When pursuing a claim before a domestic court with the domestic authorities, it's important, again, to realize that different systems vary greatly. So it's important to look at the details of the domestic system in question that you want to pursue a claim in. But there are two general systems that you can look at. One is the criminal law system, and in that system, it's generally the burden of the state and the responsibility of the state to bring the perpetrator to court and hold them to account. So you file a complaint of harassment that amounts to a criminal offense, the state can take over the prosecution. That means that generally speaking, there's less of a burden on you, though often you will have to provide evidence. Another potential drawback can be that even though there can be a criminal penalty imposed on the perpetrator, there is little room in most legal systems for receiving individual compensation. The other option is bringing a civil complaint, in which case the burden lies exclusively on you. That means that you have to build the case, pursue it, etc. That can sometimes be a significant drawback. On the other hand, there is a possibility there to receive, for example, compensation for the harm that you have suffered. Now, let's take a look at the types of action that can be pursued. First is harassment, which in most systems can be pursued as either a civil or a criminal issue. Two things are important to keep in mind when considering filing a claim on the grounds of harassment. First is that there has to have been a course of action, meaning that it has to concern more than just a single instance in which the person targeted you. The second thing is that the person targeted you needs to have had intent or reckless disregard of the consequences of those actions and of the communications. Harassment doesn't look exactly the same in every single domestic jurisdiction. For example, some countries have legislation that allows for you to pursue a harassment claim also when a message hasn't been directed at you, but is about you. So someone has made a statement about you in a public forum. In other jurisdictions, there is specific legislation that allows for you to pursue a harassment claim when someone has posted a single message, as a consequence of which others followed suit, so decided to pile on to the original message of harassment. So it's important to look at the different options that you have in the different domestic jurisdictions that are out there. The second course of action can be stalking, which in most legal systems is considered an aggravated form of harassment. In popular language, we generally think of stalking as creepily following someone around, as we see in Hollywood movies. But in practice, it can also mean pursuing a person on online platforms, on social media. It can also include posting a statement about a person or pretending to be another person, including online. Threats are another course of action. In most legal systems, there is specific legislation that makes it a criminal offense to threaten a person with specific harm, so either to injure them or to kill them or otherwise bring them discomfort. In order to be able to bring a claim on the grounds of having been threatened with any type of harm or injury, the person making the threat has to know or should have known that it was going to cause distress to the person receiving it. Hate speech or incitement can also be a course of action. It is actually an obligation under international law for states to legislate against hate speech, and many countries have legislation in place that makes it a criminal offense to incite violence, hatred, or other ill feeling towards specific groups and individuals on the basis of nationality, race, gender, etc. It is difficult, though, to sometimes balance this against the right to freedom of expression, and this is why you have to consider very carefully whether or not it's a good idea to bring a claim under this header. Because sometimes these laws are also used to actually curtail the right to freedom of expression and silence journalists. However, if the speech amounts to actual hate speech, this is also a course of action that you can consider. Finally, there are a number of civil complaints that you could file. So this could be, for example, a defamation claim. This is if someone publishes information about you that is untrue with the intent of harming you. It is important, though, to really think carefully about using these causes of action when it comes to online harassment. We'll discuss in another video that this can have significant drawbacks for the enjoyment of the right to freedom of expression as such. Determining whether or not you have a viable complaint that you can pursue depends on the jurisdiction that is applicable to the situation. This is not always easy because generally that will be the jurisdiction in which the harm occurred, which is sometimes hard to determine when dealing with the online context. Depending on what the applicable standards are, you will know what you will need in terms of evidence, proof, and other factual information in order to pursue a claim. So again, here it is important to get concrete legal advice that is targeted towards the jurisdiction in which you want to pursue your legal action.